Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to Game 2 between Alliance and Team Secret. I am here with, of course, the wonderful LD. And LD, what a game one.
Unbelievable. You know, hindsight 2020, it would have been nice if they had just ratted that game. If Lota buys back and, you know, maybe he buys BOTs, goes into the top later, even if they just let the Roche die, don't buy back and just hold the base, but... You know, no Admiral Bulldog, it's a new alliance, and they had a different approach this game. And it's, of course, very easy for us to second-guess their decisions. It was one of those frantic, crazy games where mistakes happen. They always do in Dota 2, and it's just Secret making the right calls in the clutch. But Alliance still feeling like that their overall draft was strong. So they're going to open it identically. Both teams
yep.
on the same sides with the same bands and the same first two picks, the Wisp and the Quap. But here's the difference. Now the bat goes to Secret.
Okay, and the bat. Oh, well, they've gone for the tiny and they've got it. So straight up this time, no beating around the bush, no kind of holding back. Who's going to be the partner? Alliance, they pick up the tiny, and well, tiny IO, we know how powerful it can be. But as you said, Secret with that Batrider. And Batrider for the side of Alliance, Nequid was making a lot of big plays. At the same time, though, he did throw his life away quite a lot. So we'll see what the side of Secret are able to do with the old bat. But tiny IOLD. It's going to be something that Secret need to be a little bit worried about.
Yes, you always need to be worried about this combo. It doesn't, I mean, God forbid you lose the lanes. Then you're really in trouble, right? But even if you win all the lanes, we have seen it time and again. Tiny Wisp, maybe they can't even fight and they rat you to death. Maybe they have that big comeback where Tiny gets 3 or 4 kills after picking up his axe and perhaps a +1 item. And all of a sudden, he's got more net worth than any of your cores and the game just swings and... It seems Secret want to try and cut down on how much late game Alliance have. They're going to ban out the Mag here. The Mag-Tiny combo, very devastating, of course. Empower plus Tether plus Overcharge makes for a Superman Tiny. And, you know, it kind of seems like that's the type of strategy Alliance like to run right now. Do they want to go for the Ogre again? Do we see more of the Superman carry style? Or are they going to mix it up, run more of a dual core? I'm also curious how they want to lane it, because normally the way teams run the Tiny Wisp is to dual lane mid. Once in a while, you'll see it safe lane. You very rarely see these guys go offensive tri lane, and I don't think Tiny's nearly as strong in that situation as a CK, but we'll see. For now, the bans continue. You're Bane going to get banned out again. It's a hero that fucking Mad used to love to run way back in the day, but, you know, Alliance have not run it once, so maybe it's something they're showing in scrims that we haven't seen.
Yeah, I guess it is one of those heroes that when you're playing a Quap, it is not nice to play against, in the sense that as a Quap, you try and blink in aggressively. Bane, he's going to just nightmare you. That's going to provide the rest of your team time to find themselves in a position where you're going to be able to counteract the initiation from the Quap. And our Secret, they pick themselves up the Lion. Another one of those heroes that, well, Io has got to be very, very careful where he goes this game.
Yeah, there's your Skyrat. They want a stronger laning support. Also something that can shut down the Queen of Pain, perhaps. A change-up from the Ogre. Your Tiny is already a very scary late gamer. It's kind of nice to go for the Superman draft if you can get away with it, but they're going to get someone that has a little bit more reliable lockdown. Still, for Secret, more emphasis on strong lane, strong early to mid-game, and it seems like that's just where how this team likes to play nowadays. We saw it a lot at DAC with their Shadow Fiend Quaps being prioritized occasionally, like the Broodmother or the Bristleback. Secret overall as a team, when they had the old roster, it seemed like they loved to just play for late game. And it was a slightly different patch, I guess, but we'd always see them like that 4 protect 1, just keep on farming up Kuro when he was in the carry role and they had No-Tail on the team and just play for late game. But nowadays, it seems like they really have changed up their overall approach to Dota, very much emphasizing early game aggression, lane dominance, taking objectives quickly. And, well, that game, it didn't go according to plan, but they're still going to stick with the overall formula.
They certainly are, and we'll see if they're able to pull it off a little bit more effectively this time. And now, well, we've got the side of Team Secret with their fourth pick. We've got the support. We've got... Oh! We're going to have the Phantom Assassin picked up. So, oh, man. This is not going to be a nice game for Ake.
Once this PA gets BKB, Alliance have nothing to deal with it. Aside from Tiny just praying for some right clicks to come through. It doesn't seem like they're overly phased by it. They're just going to calmly go into clockwork here. Not a great late game solution to PA, but It is a good setup for the Skywrath as well as the Relocate ganks, and generally that's what you want. When you run a Tiny Wisp or any Wisp combo, you really want that hero like a Batrider or Clockwork, and they should be the ones who start the fights. So the Tiny Wisp, if they have to go in first, and you see that Relocate on the map, well, if you're Secret, then you just have the entire team TP and encounter gank. But if Clock starts the fights, then that's the ideal formula. So it looks like now they'll be needing their final core. And this is really going to come down to if they want to run the Tiny Wisp mid, which is kind of the default way to do it. If they do, they probably want a stronger safe laner, someone who can deal with the Queen of Pain more easily. If they're going to run it safe lane, then it's going to be an easier lane mid. It's a Phantom Assassin mid for now. It's also a hero that can sit back and farm from safety. That's the other thing to keep in mind. So if they want to run the PA mid for Arteezy, which is kind of what I'm expecting here, then you don't have to go in for CS. You just throw your dagger, get easy creeps.
I do indeed, and it's going to be the ban out on the Wyvern Rages. So looking at, as you're saying, with Alliance's draft, so you don't reckon they'll put the clock in the solo safe against the Quap and run kind of an aggressive dual lane with the Scarf and their final pick?
They could.
Yeah?
It used to be pretty... There was a period where... I think it might have been Team Liquid. Was it one of Bulba's old teams, I think, was running... Oh, yeah, it was during TF4, I think. They were the team that really started running a lot of Skywrath, and I don't know if I'd say they were the first, but they were one of the first. And they would run Skywrath Wisp together, and they would just kind of dual roam. Now, they're very squishy, but they haven't saved Burst. So, I mean, it's possible they look to go aggressive here. These two do have some kill potential, but it's very risky. Especially if you're running the clock safe lane, it's like you're going to lose that lane, or a best break even versus a Batrider Queen of Pain. And if you don't completely dominate the enemy safe lane, then you're so screwed moving into the mid game and the late game. You'll be underleveled. That was the one downside of the offensive tri-lane we saw last game, was Wisp did not get a quick level 6, and I think that really set Alliance back on their heels. So I expect more likely dual lane mid, Tiny Wisp, maybe they go safe lane with it, but I think we'll just see the Clockwork as the solo offlane. Maybe they rotate in a support to help him out, but I don't think aggro try here.
Okay, and so finally picking up the Treant, so in case we do see, whoever is it put in that mid lane is going to have that extra form of backup, which they certainly will need if they are going to be up against this Tiny IO combination. Final pick now for Alliance. Maybe this will make their plans a little bit more clearer, and maybe they are going to want to try and pick something to deal with the Treant, because at the moment there's no kind of damage over time that's going to be able to deal with those living armor. Oh, they're going to go with the Storm. Okay, so the Storm picking it up against the Treant can be quite a bold move, because anytime Storm looks for a gank, living armor is going to be there to back up the teammate on the side of Secret, and going to make it a lot harder for Pycat to burst them down.
Yeah, this is a risky Storm game. He's up against Lion, so a natural hex,
yes,
good burst
yeah.
damage with Finger, Batrider with the lasso, and then PA, someone who can, or sorry, not PA, Queen of Pain, who can, I'm looking at the PA while I'm thinking about the Queen of Pain, who can build the Orchid. So, in theory, like, three of Secret's heroes, I would say, can hard counter Storm, potentially, but, it also often can be the Clock who starts the fights, maybe even the Tiny Wisp going first, and it really gives Alliance a lot of late game here. The Storm Tiny Wisp combo is... any deficiencies the Clockwork and Skywrath Mage have as the game goes later will be made up for. And, to be honest, if Clockwork ever gets farmed, he's a pretty potent late gamer. Who was it? It was Olaf for... Or no, sorry, it was Jonas. It was Jonas for NIP who showed just how scary a late game Clockwork really can be. So earlier in the Summit 3, he ended up getting like 4 hookshots in a row, like as they were sieged to the enemy base, kept the enemy team in the well as they took down Cloud9. I think there's still be nightmares about that series. But so anyway, Alliance, very good late game, but this is a very risky Storm pick. And it's something that if Secret get a decent start on their Queen of Pain or their Lion, Batrider's pretty much guaranteed to get a blink for Zai. They could really punish this Storm. So we'll see what kind of a start Alliance have here.
And we'll see if it all kicks off at this instant rune spawn at the beginning as it did in the first game. But let's introduce the teams. Secret versus Alliance on the Radiant Secret. Are they going to be having S4 this time on the Queen of Pain? And potentially in the shadow of Zai, who did a pretty spectacular performance on the offlane Quap in the first game. So we'll see what S4 can do in return. Zai this time going to be manning up on the Batrider, Puppy on that support tree, and Kuro on the Lion. And your carry is, of course, going to be Arteezy on the PA. And I'm joined today by LD. You're going to tell me what's going on the side of the Dire, aren't you?
I sure am. We've got Mad playing that Scareth Mage. Looks like he wants to potentially plop down a lane ward here. He's heading up that way. Loda camping up the rune for now with Pykep by his side. There will be no level 1 fight. For once, we'll be spared the bloodbath early on. But Ake, playing your Wisp once again, reprising his role there. And that will leave in the offlane Mr. Niqua. Boots first, clockwork already. Looking to block some creeps. We'll probably see him cog them into the tree line and just look to get as much experience as he can. It is not going to be the PA mid, which is normally where the hero tends to be played. It will be a safe lane PA. They're going to run the Queen of Pain mid. Now, to be fair, all of Secret's heroes are pretty good heroes, even against the Tiny Wisp. The PA can sit back, so too can the Quap and the Batrider. So I think S4 should have an okay time here. One of the better heroes against the Tiny Wisp.
Yeah, Quap should certainly do all right in this mid lane. Top lane, Zai. Trying to go aggressive on Matt. Matt's got a couple of stacks of napalm. Zai's only level 1. Has got the Firefly. In fact, he's just trying to man up against the Scarf Mage. Pycat and Matt trying to get the bat away. But Puppy is there on the sidelines. Hasn't skilled anything yet. Waiting to see if Leech Seed or Living Armor is going to be more preferential for this point of the game. But Zai just manning up and getting away with it. And Magicka and Pycat at this point not able to do too much against the Batrider.
Yeah, this is a lane that could go either way, I think. In general, the Batrider would struggle here, but with the tree by his side, if someone gets caught out of position, then they could quickly just get demolished here. So it's going to come down to positioning. For now, Matt is sitting pretty far back. It is two ranged heroes, and already the magic stick comes out for Pycat, so he'll have a lot of regen to work with. This sticky napalm spam is a Storm's best friend early, as long as he doesn't get dove with it. As they go in mid, a little bit of aggression here from Alliance. They have some kill potential against Queen of Pain, but as long as that blink is available, they don't have the burst damage to kill her instantly yet, so she should be able to blink out from any aggression, at least for now. They're going on top lane, though. Oh, Zai. There's your concussive shot. They want to commit to this one. Mad, is he going all the way in? No, not quite. But hey, threatening.
Yeah, only had the mana there for one arcane bolt, which wouldn't have quite been enough. And would have maybe cancelled the healing salve, though, that Zai is going to get the full use of. And Zai, just, they're trying to turn it around. This is a good time to go on the Storm. You know, you've hit level 2 on your back, you've got Firefly and the sticky napalm, and Pycat, he's managed to pick up the boots now, but still, Zai with that superior movement speed. And mid lane, Quap, S4, getting beaten right back, and a lot of space being created. Ake doing a brilliant job in the mid lane for the Tiny, and Tiny, he's managing to lead the CS at the moment, 10. Up against the Quap 6, so S4 having a little bit of a tricky time here.
It seems like Ake actually hit level 3 first because I think he got a bounty rune or two going his way, and unfortunately, if that was a Loda level 3 there when they went in, it looks like they would have gotten the kill with the extra point in the toss or even the avalanche, which he is choosing to max first, so bit unfortunate, but still, this is how strong Tiny Wisp are. Even a Queen of Pain can die to the combo if she's not careful, and it will be very important for S4 to constantly be on full HP. He may even want to get some cheap stats item, like an early Null Talisman. I don't think we'll see a Bracer in Queen of Pain, but even completing Magic Wand early could be a nice choice. His bottom lane, they catch out Niqua.
I think he might go down in the Hex from Kuroki and staggering those stuns and lockdowns perfectly, allowing Arteezy to get those hits in. And that's going to put, well, the side of Secret in a good place. Unfortunately for Arteezy, he didn't get the first blood. Kuroki took that gold, but Kuroki now sitting on 1,000 gold. He's got a lot of money to spend on all kind of delights.
1,000 already. Oh, man. Top lane. They are going to... It looks like they're going to put the bat in the jungle now. So they'll leave the off lane for the tree. Play a little greedier. Potentially, this tree could go down if Puppy's out of position. But even if he dies, it's really not a big deal. Storm as well as Scarth Mage do not push particularly hard. So they're not going to take a tower off of any kills, and ultimately it's just a Treant Protector. So he'll get some extra experience. Zai will be the one trying to take advantage of the jungle, and it looks like a quick blink coming for the Lion, as you mentioned. He's already up to... Well, it looks like he bought something, maybe a new set of wards, but still sitting on 850 gold, and he could have that very early blink. Top lane, though. Well, top secret shop, I should say. Alliance able to find a kill here on the tree. Good rotation. The Skywrath Wisp, very squishy, but extremely high damage output.
Yeah, Scarf, he snagged a haste rune from the tree, and Tree was trying to man up and did bring the sky down very low, but Magicka was baiting it out because he had the backup of Ake, and Ake was able to turn around the little confrontation very nicely, because one more punch from the tree would have brought the Skywrath down, so some very nice play there from Alliance. Gets themselves a kill on the board. And as you said, Jeff Lyon, we were already talking on how well he's, how good he is against the Storm and heroes like the IO in particular. If he can get that blink online very early, say before the Storm even thinks about building towards his Orchid, it's going to be pretty disastrous for Alliance.
Yes, it is. It is. It is not only bad for the Storm, it's actually bad for, I would say, at least two other heroes. The Skyrim, yeah, as well as the Wisp. Those three are all just food for a lion with a blink. You blink in, you throw out the finger, that may be enough to kill the Wisp just on its own, and if it's not, then, or the Skywrath, and certainly with a stun or any kind of follow-up, it will be a kill. So it's a scary position to be giving up that fast blink dagger, and we'll see if Kroki wants to go right towards it. He did spend all his gold here, so it looks like for now he's going to go into Tranquil Boots, a very standard item on Lion. It's not a blink, but it does give you a lot of extra move speed. He doesn't tend to have mana issues because he has the mana drain to work with, and so he'll be able to just move around the map quicker, control runes a little more effectively, gets the Bracer as well. That's another important thing. Against Tiny Wisp, you really want to have as much HP as possible. I mentioned the early Null Talisman for us forwards, a good item on Queen of Pain anyway, and this, I expect we'll see a lot of these cheap stats items on Seeker just to help them live through the burst and then look to turn the fights from there.
I'd imagine so indeed. In bottom lane, Loda, he's guarding up the Invis rune. In comes Ayoake. Going to get that for the bottle charges. They're not going to be able to look to anything aggressive. Arteezy continuing to farm very well. 41 CS at the moment. He's top of the board, 6 minutes in, and maybe Nick was in trouble. There's your Earth Spike. There is going to be a Hex as well. He's level 7, but Arteezy not quite finding the crits there onto the clockwork. Maybe in a bit of trouble now as the burst damage from the Scarath does come out. Nikwa at level Arke's 5 doesn't have hook shot. And oh yeah, Vake can get himself tethered up to Majka, top him up in terms of mana. Maybe they can look to go in on this. Ancient Seal, it's back off cooldown. Io, just trying to zone it. Ake, he's going for it.
He is invis, yeah.
Jesus, God,
I hate
it.
That,
yeah,
with Wisp. You can't tell see unless it. You look at the buff indicators.
I was like, what is he doing?
Are they blind? What are these idiot pro players doing? Don't they see this Wisp? But yeah, it is of course invis. So they didn't see this rune get picked up, but they did see Ake go off the map and hide. So they're going to play a little more defensively as a result. And you know, with the early treads Akila, Arteezy is very tanky, and even Kuroki has that Bracer Tranquil Boot, so I don't think these heroes are quite as... Plus, as you mentioned earlier, the Living Armor, that's always the X-Factor, so wisely Alliance not going to try to commit, but now, well, it's time for Seeker to go in bottom. They find a kill on the clockwork. Arteezy should be okay, but it's going to drop fairly low to this tower here.
Oh, nice pickoff there, and again, Kuro finding the kill himself. So Arteezy not getting that bonus gold that I'm sure he'd be quite happy with at this point. Even so, the farming's going fine for Arteezy. Come back to 50 CS, and comes a zip. Pycat, he wants to try and find it. Kurokoki just kind of stands there staring at him going, come on, mate, you want some. He did have the stun and
that
the hex of
it. Really unfortunate. That's all of his mana. look at this puppy, Invis. He knows that the tiny's off. He sees the tiny off the map. He knows he's looking for the stacks, but I don't think Puppy can get this done on his own, and they don't really have any backup here. Zai just taking over mid. He's about to get his Blink Dagger. Puppy gonna ward off that camp. This is always the struggle. Oh, they might close the distance here, though. Ake Mad could be caught out. Oh, they see Puppy. The orb's gonna hit him, and he'll just quickly go invis back out. But yeah, the overall game is really gonna come down to Alliance just trying to farm here. They want to get the Storm, that Bloodstone, or maybe Orchid as quickly as possible. Your Tiny Wisp, as always, just going to be going for the Tiny Eggs, and one of the good ways to really stop that is to either block the camps or to ward the jungle so you know when they're farming them and can either go on the heroes there or even look to punish them elsewhere on the map. So with this camp blocked, they'll have some good vision in the dire jungle and just look to grind this Alliance economy to a halt.
Certainly so far as we're coming into the 9 minutes, let's have a look at the net worth for the individual heroes. Arteezy is at the top. Yeah, just a little bit ahead of the Tiny and the Storm for the side of Alliance. So in terms of share and farm, Alliance is working out for them. Loda and, of course, Pycat doing fairly well at this point of the game. But it's kind of going to come down to how impactful this Storm can be. You know, it's him sitting at level 8 now. He's got the Soaring on top of the treads, and he is level 8. At the moment, just looking to clear up some of the stacks in this jungle. And even when he does look to rotate and gank, I'm just having trouble finding and kind of anticipating the openings he's going to be able to look for, because Secret, they've just got so many ways to deal with him, and this might be it. Zai with the blink, finding Pycat. Kuroki is there, hasn't got the finger. I think they're going to be able to burst him down. There was even an ult from the low ground, didn't contact. They didn't need it. S4 just wanted to get a little bit of a look into that kill, and Batrider finds that kill, and a very, very profitable first use of the blink dagger there.
That is one of the two ideal kills. If you kill him or you kill the Tidy, you're always going to be happy. Bottom lane, Arteezy. Going to Niqua here. He's looking for a crit or two. Needs a little bit more. He actually gets pulled into tower and by the cogs. And with that, he is going to blink out. Cancels the bottle charge of Niqua, who has to be careful that the blink is on cooldown. It's only a level 1 Phantom Strike. Another movement here by Secret. They have their finger of death, and they want to go right back in to find a takedown with this one. Tiny Wisp not nowhere to be found. Your Storm nowhere to be found either. Alliance actually trying to set up here, but I think that's something Secret will expect, given that they don't see anyone in the jungle. They see two heroes top. That puts two off the map now. Storm, as well as Skywrath. And it seems that Arteezy going to back off and play it safe.
Well, he certainly needs to, with Storm and the Sky, as you said, waiting to zip in and start the fight. Niqua with the hook shot as well. Anyone that comes into lane here could be in a lot of trouble. Secret, Arteezy, does get flared up. But
a lot of wasted time for Pycat here.
It is, yeah.
Even if they get that kill, it's kind of like a... I wouldn't say it's an even trade, but it's a slight win for Lynch, just because Storm farms very quickly. He clears the waves quickly. He can go into the jungle and farm the stacks, but... It seems like Alliance are just afraid to be in these lanes, and we can see why. The Batrider's got a blink, Les is off cooldown, Finger hasn't been used yet, and you've also got the tree factor. You could be walking around with Nature's Guise, you can get ambushed out of nowhere, and as a result, their economy is not what it could be. They're still looking okay on their cores, but you know, the big worry is these supports. Wisp still not quite level 6 in 12 minutes, about to get it. If a Wisp snowballs, we sometimes see the Wisp, Tiny Wisp duo mid get level 6 for the Wisp by, you know, even like the 7-8 minute mark with a couple of bounty runes, a kill or two on the enemy mid, but it just hasn't been one of those explosive games for Alliances. I do want to point out, they tried to deward this camp OD, but they missed it. They really need those stacks, and unfortunately, not able to find it.
That is unfortunate, and that is going to hinder this Tiny and Io's growth quite a lot. Tiny, he picked up the point booster, then went for the... he was got the Gloves of Haste, so I guess rather than finishing the Axe, going to get the Midas to help him on his way to the late game.
It is a good item on Tiny, in theory, if you're allowed to get away with it, but it's one of those things where like you farm super quick with the Axe, but if you get a Midas and an Axe, in theory, you can farm a little bit quicker. So it will delay his potential Aghanim Scepter pickup. Well, I mean, not potential. It's a guarantee he'll get it at some point, but... You know, if Secret sees this Gloves of Haste, they may look to punish it. And even if they see the Midas complete, that's like, okay, great. Tiny has a Midas. There's no eggs. We can just go fight right now. So let's see if this gets scouted out. For now, there's a smoke. Tiny is shown here, but Mad trying to set something up for his team top lane. And at the same time, it looks like they may make a go for Secret bottom. No blink just yet in Kuro, but they've got the PA to close the gap and set up.
Yeah, both sides need to be careful on their respective lanes. S4, if he comes out, he's going to get hit very hard in the face here by the Tiny and Aya. And Aya, with this relocate, maybe they'll look to try and turn around on another lane. Zai is not revealing himself in mid yet, waiting to see if Alliance decide to push the issue there. But no, it's top lane that Alliance are definitely focusing on. Three heroes, four heroes, if you include Pycat there on the back of it. And Tiny, as you said, he's got his Midas complete now. But if Secret, if they're aware of this, which I'm sure they will be, they'll know that this is the time to fight. This is the time to catch out Loda, which they haven't been able to do so far because, well, Loda and Ake, they've pretty much been in the jungle for the entirety of this poor kind of last few minutes of this game.
And you can see they're fighting for table scraps here, you know? The Storm is going to farm one stack here. Tiny, it's like, well, I guess I'll go mid. This is just not ideal when you're running this duo. Whereas you look across the way at Secret, they've got all three of their cores farming, and crucially, Kuroki up to 1,000 gold now with the Bracer and the Tranquil Boots. He's also been the man buying a lot of wards for his team. Now he will look to get that Blink Dagger. He's going to TP top. There is a lane ward here, though. If he moves even a few inches forward, he'll be spotted out, but he doesn't. He gets smoked up. This could be a beautiful initiation for Secret.
Oh, it really could. Loda And Ake, are they going to think it's their day to jump a nose for? No, it's not, because Finger straight away from Kuroki onto the IO, bringing him out of the fight. Lasso was used as well, but they get themselves the kill. 4-1, a TP in to this top lane. Now Magicka and Loda, they're all on their own, though. Arteezy continuing to farm up as much as he can in the jungle. And, well, we're going to see that build, that item on PA that sometimes gets flamed in pubs, LD. It's going to be the Battle Fury PA.
Yeah, it looks like Arteezy. Okay, it gets flamed in pubs, but it's not a bad item on PA by any stretch. It is situational. I think there are some games where you need your PA to come to fights earlier. Oh, that mid lane jump. You got a crit on the dagger and then another crit for good measure, I believe. And with that, gets the kill. Meanwhile, top action going to break out here. They blink it with Zai. They don't have a lasso right now. Loda, chuck it up. Kuro can't get the kill, though. Perhaps the turn comes. Hookshot in from Niko, chasing out Kuroki. A great overgrowth. Catches out all three, but only used defensively to try and retreat. Kuro, still no money here for the blink dagger. No mana for a TP out. He's got the stick coming off cooldown soon. S4 going to go down. Kuroki, try to TP out Niko. There's your backup. It's arrived in the form of Arteezy with the Battle Fury. Brains down. One, make it two. Gets the clock as well. Tiny going to be forced back now. And it looks like with that kill, they may be able to take a tower here as well. There's a smoke from Alliance. They want to go back in. Okay, this will not be expected.
Oh boy.
By Secret.
Yeah, this is a...
This definitely will not be expected.
It won't be expected.
Storm has a TP, but...
But, I mean, two heroes. Just the Tiny and Magicka.
Look at the HP on Loda. He's so low.
He's gone... Yeah. He's going to go for it, though. There's your Avalanche and toss onto Lion. The Living Armor helping Kuroki out, but he does manage to get out of the Earthspike. And then Living Armor again. Kuroki is still alive. Is he going to be able to get out of this? He's very close to the Blink Dagger as well. It's going to be a little bit unfortunate if he goes down. Nature's Guys isn't going to protect him from that one. It's a Lion's fine one pick off. Puppy walks straight under the shower from the Mystic Flare. And, well, Lions, they do it. They hang around with this Tiny, the backup from the IO, and, well, Niko.
They are going to relocate for this, but it's kind of into an awkward position in the middle of the river. Zai will TP out, so relocate baited out. He'll get out safely, and as well as the hookshot used. Not the longest cooldown spells, but still. I think overall Secret, it's a slight win for them there. The graph actually dips, but they did get the tower, as well as a couple of kills, and crucially, your PA did not die. Arteezy still the leader in net worth. He's just farming up these Aatrox now. He's maxed the Blur first, which I think is the better build if you just want to be jungling and clearing stacks with the increased evasion. If you want to fight a lot, the Phantom Strike cooldown improves and scales really well, but it seems like for Arteezy, it's going to be more about clearing stacks, farming as efficiently as possible. I'm curious to see the next item. At some point this game, BKB feels mandatory. You're up against the Storm, who's likely to build an Orchid, in fact, is going for one. The Mystic Flare hookshot, the Tiny Avitas combo. It's just the question of if that BKB is his next item or if he saves it for a bit later on.
Either way, he's going to get whatever he needs next very quickly, as you were saying, with this full-on focus on keeping the farm up with the skill build and the item build and the Battle Fury and the maxed out Blur with that mask. It's certainly going to help Arteezy get whatever he wants. Bottom lane. They want S4. The hook shot, though. Oh, blocked by the creeps. Niko uses it to close the gap, but maybe it doesn't matter because here's Pycat. And they're going to find it with the Ancient Seal Silence. And Pycat gets himself involved just in time in that fight.
They do have Relocate available. So at any moment, it could be five heroes bottom. Something that Secret do have to be careful about. They're smoked right now. Kuroki, no blink yet, but they have the Zai initiation. They could get caught by a relocate ambush, though. They need to bring him down quickly. Lasso, finger, a smooth kill. And he did buy his Oblivion Staff, so at least he spends his gold. Now top lane, making a go on Puppy here. He worms his way to the trees. He's just out of the first entry, but not out of the second. There's the chuck, drops the overgrowth. They're gonna have to commit for this one if they wanted, and it looks like they won't be able to get the kill. He struts away. Double sentry, gets nothing done.
A nice use of overgrowth there, and again, just this living armor doing so much work, and these heroes just not being able to burst through all the layers of it. And Loda, he still continues to get scarier and scarier with the Axe complete, 1k gold on top of that. But still, Arteezy with the lead in terms of net worth by 1,000. And looking at the overall grass, 5k XP advantage in both, well, in the gold as well, going the way of Secret. So Secret, 19 minutes in a fairly confident position.
Very manageable game for Alliance. It is a big lead, as they're going to make a gigantic jump onto Kuroki, finally. The Storm zips from, like, here, plus the hookshot. It's just a rough game for Hero League Lion. If you're spotted pretty much anywhere on the map, they can relocate on you. Maybe you can set up an Earth Spike to counter initiate on the Wisp, but it's not going to be easy. But yeah, I don't know, OD. Both teams. Oh, Arteezy. Could get caught mid. He just blinked in to farm the creep wave. Now he's got no way out. Toss. Mystic Flare. They got him. We'll get the job done. That was a pretty aggressive blink. Normally, we don't see the blink used to farm, but it does increase your attack speed. And Arteezy, he's just in the wrong place at the wrong time. Gets punished.
And off the back of that.
That's a big one.
They lose a tier 1. Gold sweep. Fortification comes out, but I mean, Loner.
Nice.
Yeah, he's cool to stick around. Living Armor isn't going to be able to save you. And yeah, without the PA, Team Secret just not in a position to fight up against this aggression. And a little bit more money in Loda's pockets. And Loda, 2.5k gold. Now, what does he go for next, Mr. Aldi?
Your go-to build here is... I mean, I think Manta's always going to be a good item just because you can maybe bait out the Hex from the Lion. Potentially disjoint some incoming spells. If Queen of Pain silences you, you can Manta out of that. Manta's an option. He's gonna go AC, which is also kind of a standard item. The big question with Tiny is always, like, do you have to build a BKB this game? It's one of the things about the hero that's annoying when you have a Wisp on your team, is you really don't want to go BKB if you can avoid it, because then your Wisp can't tether to you, and ultimately, when the BKB wears off, you're much less scary in teamfights. This game, I would say, I'm not really sure if he needs one. He may even want to go into some evasion to deal with the PA. If you get a BKB, there's still the Lasso, there's still the Overgrowth. And that's the thing for Secret, is they have really good lockdown to deal with a farm Tiny. It's where you need a farm Storm as well. Pycat does have his Orchid, and I think because Pycat's having a decent time, Alliance is still in good shape. Even if their supports are poor, this Tiny, Wisp, Storm, these three can go around the map killing pretty much any hero at any time. Late, the game goes late enough, you get a Hex on the Storm, and to me, he's almost more important than Loda as a hero. Obviously, they're both crucial, but if he's not farmed, then they're just not going to be able to fight.
Bottom lane. Yeah, Nikro and Pycat, they've found a bit of action here. There's going to be a Hex from Kuroki. Barad is silenced up, has got the lasso. Is he going to be able to get it off before Nikro does any funny business? He doesn't even need it by the looks of it. Well, he's not going to get the chance. Ancient Seal, Loda, and Ake coming in with a relocate from behind, blowing up the Batride. And, that's Batrider down in a situation where Alliance looked like they were going to get caught out there.
Arteezy does have BKB now, though. They lose their Batrider, and he may be forced to use this BKB. I assume Pycat's seated here. Trying to bait it out, Arteezy. Not committing just yet. They get off the Quap Silence of Pycat. Now the Wisp comes in, trying to save him. Both gonna tank the ult. One down. It may well be two. Hake will also fall, trying to save a buddy, and gets punished for it. Nice takedown there, and he didn't even have to use the BKB. They may look to push off of that.
Certainly looks like they're gonna go for it. Tier 2 taking a lot of damage. Tiny hasn't got the eye to back him up. Loda deciding to just continue to farm and push up the top lane. Looks like they might just sack this tier 2, the side of Alliance, without the Storm, without the Io. Not going to be able to do too much, and indeed, Arteezy, he's going to be... No, S4. S4 takes the tower gold there, and S4 now with 2k gold on top of the Orchid, and now on top of the BKB, Arteezy with 1.6. What's the plan? Well, it looks like Roshan might be the plan. Are they going to go for Roche, or is it a little bit too risky? And I guess it's a little bit too risky with the Storm back up and Alliance. Everyone is back on the map now.
They really need their Batrider if they want to go for Roche. Need him for the map control, the vision around the pit, and as well as just the lasso setup. I think for Secret here, your plan is probably to get a BKB on the other cores at this point. Zai maybe gets Boots of Travels first, but... BKB solves a lot of their issues. Most of the damage from Alliance is magic. The only exception is the Tiny right-clicks, but they have solutions to stop them from right-clicking in teamfights. They have the Overgrowth, they have the Lasso, the PA can somewhat deal with him through evasion, so I think if we see a BKB come out for S4, he does pick up an Ogre Club. I mean, technically it could be the Ags, but I'm expecting BKB here. And once they get those, that's where Secret will look to play really aggressive. They could go late, maybe match up against Alliance, but their ideal scenario is to snowball this, end it early, don't get into that situation where Tiny is base trading, don't end up against the Wisp late game. Sure, they won last time around, but it really came down to the dieback from Loda, and it's just a situation you want to avoid if at all possible.
Oh, the fight potentially going to kick off. Loda backseat himself an Invis room Secret.
They did want a gem, by the way. He has just put a bullseye on his back with this pickup.
Oh, and that is going to be the tier one going down. Oh, Alliance. They do want to try and find this fight. They've come straight into the Radiant Jungle. Loader trying to catch someone out here. Trying to wrap himself around. Has got that completed AC Alliance. They see Secret in the river. There's the blink up from Bat. In fact, well, it's the initiation from Niqua. Hookshot onto Puppy, but gets hexed up straight away before he can get the cogs down. Arteezy trying to slash away the Phantom Strike. There's the ult from Queen of Pain. That is going to be the clockwork down. Nice overgrowth, holding Loader and Ake in place. And that is giving Arteezy time to clean up elsewhere. Storm's got down as well. Phantom Strike onto Ake, but the relocate out is going to be able to save the Tiny.
Well, they're going to lose the Wisp. They may lose Matt as well here. He's trapped out. It's going to be a 4-0 exchange as the Wisp almost certainly goes down upon the relocate back. There's a dog pile here bottom. Tries for the tether, but into the waiting arms of the Queen of Pain Scream, he will go. Ends up going down to the Lion. And, well, the big thing here, it's not even really the kills. It's the fact that now they can walk into the pit, take this Aegis. Arteezy, he'll be the man in. This is the stage of the game where the PA matches up exceptionally well against the Tiny Wisp. Can just go in, burst the Wisp almost instantly. The BKB makes Arteezy immune to, I mean, basically all the damage Alliance has. A lot of magic damage, the tiny right-click's unlikely to do much. You're dealing with so much evasion for Arteezy right now, sitting on the 50% blur. It's been buffed a lot over the past year or so, and now he gets a Basher. So with this, he can easily manfight and destroy Loda with the BKB. There is very little chance they kill him. They're going to have to bait out the BKB charges, and I think at this point they look for little pickoffs like the one they're finding now on Zai in the Dire Jungle. They'll bring him down. Not the gem carrier currently, though. The gem's still on Puppy. Very fortunate, because you often see the bat as the one who wields it. But yeah, I think this is the stage of the game where Alliance just have to wait out the Aegis, stall, avoid fights if at all possible, or if they take fights, be very selective. They are not that strong right now in the clash.
Well, they certainly aren't. This is definitely the portion of the game that Arteezy is going to be able to run circles around the lineup of Alliance. And Loader, how's he going? He's going to head straight down to the bottom lane, just continuing to focus on getting that farm and work on his next item. He's got the mine. There we go. Yeah, okay. Mine was available. He uses it. It's all cool. Loader knows what he's doing. And after the AC, what does he go for now? As you were saying, BKB isn't really going to offer him too much protection. Nice against the Lion, but at the same time, I guess you're kind of hoping that the Lion is going to be focusing on other heroes, because everyone else on the side of Secret, they're going to be fine, even if they're playing up against a BKB. So BKB isn't really going to be the answer here. So what is on top of the AC?
Manta's really good against Overgrowth. He almost has to reserve it for when the Overgrowth comes out. I think you probably go Manta, Butterfly. Maybe you still get the BKB just to deal with the Lion Hex. Lion has so much good lockdown that just to deal with him, you almost still want to consider a BKB, but I think more likely you look into your Manta, Butterfly, like the best split pushing items the Tiny has in his arsenal, and just avoid fights. I don't see them taking fights until Storm gets a whole lot scarier. Piecat, probably when Piecat gets BKB and one more item, like maybe Bloodstone BKB or Hex BKB, then they can look for some fights, but this is, as we've been talking about, just that stage of the game where Secret, not only Aegis, but just a stronger team in fighting anyway at this moment. And, well, we're going to see a jump in bottom. Piecat trying to find that tree. He really wants to take this gem away, but instead it's going to be Mad who ends up going down here first and foremost. Overgrowth will catch him out. Maybe not, though. He gets up the silence. They want Puppy. Give me that friggin' gem, you big, ugly tree. But they can't even get the kill just yet. He's low. He ends up going invis again. They don't even take him down, and now, well, Tiny Wisp, they'll lose the Wisp. The Tiny gonna be sent back to the mid lane, and it looks like when it's all said and done, they lose three. It's all about the stinking gem right now. They just want it so damn bad, OD, but they just can't get the job done.
Absolutely not. They committed a lot there. They relocated in, but can't bring down Puppy. The overgrowth's perfectly timed, so Alliance can't fight themselves around it. And wow, Secret want more. They found Loader. Oh, this is going to be a big kill. Alliance with three heroes down. If they can kill the Tiny and the Storm here with that Earth Spike, I think they will. Arteezy pops the BKB. He hasn't got time for any craggy exteriors slowing this independent woman down. No. PA there cleaning up. And they're going to get the tier two as well. And Secret, I think they might be just ready to go to the high ground, LD.
After that game one where it looked like Alliance might just steal it away from Secret, then Secret end up being the thieves in the end, and now they may just take a full lane of Rex here. Alliance, in the winner's bracket, so even should they lose this game, they will have a shot to bounce back, and they do look like one of the scarier teams in the qualifier, but well, it's just been secret in the right place at the right time. Now the tower gonna fall. They still have the Aegis. No BKB available for Arteezy. The Aegis, it looks like, has about a minute remaining. Just an ideal time for Secret to cave in a lane of Rax. And, you know, I almost want to say they could go for two now, but the safe play is probably to get the next Aegis before you do it.
I guess so. They have got that little bit of a window before Tiny Loader is back up. Secret, are they going to play it cool? Are they going to play it safe? Looks like they will. Puppy teepers himself down to the bottom lane. Wants to continue to find that farm towards the... Wait, hang on. Doesn't even need to. Aghanim's is complete on Treant. That's, I mean, you just don't win games against that.
300 minute game hype confirmed. At least it's a tree who's ahead getting the eggs here, so...
Yes, it's not a comeback a item.
Oh god, that item is just disgusting if you're playing for behind. I don't know if you caught that, but there was a Skyrath mage here. I didn't even see him die. Just saw the blood on the ground. As Pycat will get counter initiated on bottom lane. He's trying to make plays. Man, he wants this freaking gem so bad, but it will be thwarted once again. They are just protecting Puppy nicely. And at this point, your Storm not snowballing. The Tiny not really able to fight the PA. Is going to try to build a BKB, but... I mean, it's a damned if you do, damned if you don't kind of item. There are so many ways to deal with this. The Hex to disable him before he pops the BKB. The PA now has a completed evasion anyway just to man fight him. And of course, on top of that, your Lasso, your Overgrowth. I don't know. This BKB may be necessary because they're about to lose a lane of Rax otherwise, but may also not even matter. Relocate, coming inside, almost cancels it with the Flame Break, but not quite able to. And now the Clash breaks out.
Yeah, Nequa tried to initiate there onto the PA, but it ended up going a way that he didn't kind of want it to start off going, and Arteezy just turns it around. And Kuroki, again, with these plays, with these stuns and these fingers, blowing up Alliance, losing the Aya, losing the...
Can you imagine Psy cancels that? He almost canceled both. He almost just disrupted the relocate there, and, and then they're completely screwed. Then they're fighting. I guess they could try to TP back, but he could lasso... and potentially stop at least one of those, just keep the Tiny in a position where he has to walk back to base, and, well, ends up working out anyway. They're gonna cave into tier 3, and this may well be their second lane of Rax. Secret wasting no time in trying to end this game.
23-9 on the board. It's not looking great for the side of Alliance. Loader, even with the amount of farm he's got, it is just not enough. And Pycat, it's just the Storm this game hasn't had any impact at all, and it's just really struggled to find an opening to go in on Secret. And it was a fifth pick Storm, and just looking at the draft, we kind of felt that Storm wasn't going to have a great game, didn't we?
Yeah, he could have had a great game, but it would have been really tough. The margin for error against this draft is very small, and I Pycat at this point, it's been two times he's dove for the gem, and he's ended up paying the price, but you can't really fault him either too much. They really had to take the gem away from Secret, and it's more just Secret being ready for those jumps than anything else. But yeah, it's the point of the game now where Storm doesn't have a BKB and it's just total food, as once again Arteezy leaps on it. Now he pops his BKB and he's gonna go to work. They can't even fight against this PA. Regardless, Tony or no Tony, he ain't got enough tools in his arsenal. That will be Overgrowth held in place, and GG Secret. You know, there were starting to be some questions as well. Is Alliance, is Empire, you know, are these teams rising? Are they even going to supplant Secret and Cloud9? But Secret making their case here that they deserve to be considered as one of those top one or two teams in the European region, if not in the world. I guess EG still hold the title, at least for now. But, you know, with this win, OD, they need to win one more series and they're into the summit.
And it's certainly looking very, very good for Secret. And that was a good game for them as well. Alliance recently, not only, of course, in the summit getting this far, but also in Star Ladder, have been doing really, really well as a team. They've been taking down a lot of other big names, but Secret, obviously one of the biggest, and still just a little bit too big for Alliance to deal with. And Team Secret, they take it 2-0, and as you said, they'll be on to the next round, and I believe they will be playing up the winners of the next series, which is between Asus, Polar, and NIP, isn't it?
Yeah, whoever wins that is coming to the summit. Now, the losers still have a shot. They'll drop down here. Na'Vi, Cloud9 lurking in the lower bracket. It is going to be a real dog pile to see who claims that second spot, and for those who don't, well, there's always the redemption vote. Maybe they'll have a chance there, but, you know, no team wants to be at the mercy of the whims of the fans. You know, they want to just guarantee that they're going to the LAN and not have that stress. So, well, for Secret, I think they'll be considered the favorites going into the winner bracket finals. And should they lose there, they'll have a backup chance in the lower bracket. But for now, Secret looking like the strongest team in the tournament. And I mean, not only in terms of their play, but, you know, they have the hype and the name recognition to back it up.
I do indeed. And well, that is the series over. The next series is it's going to be at 2100 CT, I believe. So that's in about an hour and a half. So you guys, unfortunately, you've got quite a bit to wait until that game comes on. But well, we'll play you some beautiful adverts and we'll play you some beautiful tunes. So don't go anywhere.
Beautiful.
LD, look at that laugh. That's the laugh of someone who's about to make some esports dollar. LD, thank you for joining me.
Everyone uses Adblock anyway. So thanks to those who don't. But yes. Yeah, thank you for Cassio D. It was a pleasure, man. It's always fun to get to join you.
You too, LD. Thanks for joining me. But I'm going to be trading you in for David 2.0. Gods is going to be joining me for the next series. So
we'll see. I see how it is.
I'm just kidding. I love you, LD. We've got something beautiful. LD. Right, LD, I'll get rid of you. We need to make some money, so I'll talk to you later. Yeah?
Okay, thanks.
To see you about LD. Okay, boys, girls, time to run the adverts. We're going to be back later for Asus Polar versus NIP. I'm going to be joined by Gods for that one. So don't go anywhere. Well, do. You've got a little bit of time to do whatever you guys do. Get yourself a drink. Get yourself something to eat. Maybe have a little bit of a tickle with your tackle. Ladies and gentlemen, I'll see you in a bit. I'm OD Pixel. I was joined by LD Dota. OD and LD. That's it. OD Pixel on Twitter.